start. I've never known anything but hunger.
Poverty.
I've been hungry all my life. Yeah. Starved to the bone. Somewhere on this raggedy earth, somebody said something once about some kind of paradise where everything would be nice.
Poverty.
And together.
Paradise.
But I'll be damned if I can find it. I've grown up into adulthood now, and I don't seem to be able to find my way to anything, much less somebody's paradise.
Poverty's paradise.
One thing for sure, I like to go to sleeps just once on a full stomach. I get mighty tired of these belly wrinkles, dig? And my babies.
Poverty.
I don't know what I'm gonna do about them. I've run out of ways to keep them fed. Used to be I could find a way when there wasn't any way.
If you walk in this house with tears in your eyes, running from poo-poo and Prentice, go back outside, I beat your ass, little nigga. That homework better be finished. I beat your ass, your teachers better not be bitching about you in class. That pizza better not be wasted, you eat it all. That TV better not be loud if you got it on. Them Jordans better not get dirty when I just bought them. Better not hear about you humping on Keisha's daughter. Better not hear you got caught up. I beat your ass, you better not run to your father. I beat your ass, you know my patience running thin. I got boo-boo payments to make. County buildings on my ass, trying to take my food stamps away. I beat your ass if you tell them social workers he live here. I beat your ass if I beat your ass twice and you still here. 7 years old, think you run this house by yourself? Nigga, you gon' fear me if you don't fear no one else.
If I can smoke fear away, I roll that motherfucker up. A bitch, pull them panties to the side now.
I probably die anonymous, I probably die with promises. I probably die walking back home from the candy house. I probably die because these colors are standing out. I probably die because I ain't know DeMarcus was snitching. I probably die at these house parties fucking with bitches. I probably die from witnesses leaving me false accused. I probably die from thinking that me and your hood was cool. Or maybe die from pressing the line, acting too extra. Or maybe die because these smokers are more than desperate. Probably die from one of these pets and blue badges. Body slammed in black and white paint, my bones snapping. Or or maybe die from panic, or die from being too lax, or die for waiting on it, die cause I'm moving too fast. I probably die trying to buy weed at the apartments. I probably die trying to defuse two homies arguing. I probably die cause that's what you do when you're 17. My worries in a hurry, I wish I controlled things.
If I can smoke fear away, I roll that motherfucker up.
Accumulated 10 times over throughout the years. My newfound life made all of me magnified. How many accolades do I need to block denial? The shock value of my success provokes in me. All this money is God playing a joke on me. Is it for the moment and will he see me as Job? Take it from me and leave me worse than I was before. At 27 my biggest fear was losing it all. Scared to spend money had me sleeping from hard to hard. Scared to go back to Section 8 with my mama stressing. 30 shows a month and I still won't buy me no Lexus. What is an advisor? Somebody that's holding my checks just to fuck me over and put my finances in debt. I read a case about Rihanna's accountant and wonder how did the bad girl feel when she looked at them numbers. That type of shit'll make me flip out and just kill some, drill some, get ill and feel wretched with a little some. My practice running from fear, guess I had some good luck. At 27 years old, my biggest fear was being judged. How they look at me reflect on myself, my family, my city. What they say about me reveal if my reputation will miss me. What they see from me will trickle down generations in time. What they hear from me will make them highlight my simplest lines. I'm talking fear, fear losing creativity, I'm talking fear. Fear missing out on you and me, I'm talking fear. Fear losing loyalty for pride, cause my DNA won't let me involve in the light of God. I'm talking fear. Fear that my humbleness is gone, I'm talking fear. Fear that love ain't living here no more, I'm talking fear. Fear that is wickedness or weakness. Fear, whatever it is, both is distinctive. Fear, what happens on earth stays on earth, and I can't take these feelings with me, so hopefully they disperse. Within 14 tracks, carried out over wax, searching for resolutions until somebody get back. Fear, what happens on earth stays on earth, and I can't take these feelings with me, so hopefully they disperse. Within 14 tracks, carried out over wax, wondering if I'm living through fear or living through rap.
Damn.
God damn you. God damn me. God damn us. God damn we. God damn us all.
Verse 2 says, you only have I known of all the families of the earth. Therefore, I will punish you for all your iniquities. So until we come back to these commandments, until you come back to these commandments, we're going to feel this way. We're going to be under this curse. Because he said he's going to punish us, the so-called blacks, Hispanics, and Native American Indians, are the true children of Israel. We are the Israelites according to the Bible. The children of Israel, he's going to punish us for our iniquity, for our disobedience, because we chose to follow other gods. That as a man chasing his son, so the Lord thy God chasing thee. So just like you're chasing your own son, he's going to chasten you because he loved you. So that's why we get chastised. That's why we're in the position that we're in. Until we come back to these laws, statutes, and commandments and do what the Lord says, these curses is going to be upon us. We're going to be at a lower state in this life that we live here and today in the United States of America. I love you, family, and I pray for you. God bless you. Shalom.